Hey, Derek here. Welcome to lesson number two in our Traffic Crash Course series. And now I want to talk about what is the best source of targeted traffic. In our last lesson, if you missed it, there's a link to it. But if you missed it, we talked about targeted traffic, right? And the psychology of targeted traffic and what makes people targeted and not making the mistake of targeting people who are not really targeted, okay? So now that we understand targeting, where do we go to find the best sources of targeted traffic? Now, this again is a lesson to keep you from being led astray and wasting time and money in places that are not going to yield any result. Because when somebody asks me, what is the best source of targeted traffic today? Typically, they expect me to say, have you seen Instagram, or it's definitely Facebook, or it's this, or it's that. And my answer is always disappointing to them because they're expecting some absolute earth-shattering revelation of this is it, here's where you need to focus. Somebody says to me, well, where's the best source of targeted traffic? And my answer is, it depends. They kind of slump. That wasn't the answer hoping for. The fact is, every market is different. And some markets exist on some platforms and not on others. Or they may exist on a platform, but it's just not the right place to reach them, because that's not where they're actively thinking about or interested in what you have to offer. Your best source of targeted traffic may not be the same as mine, may not be the same as hers or his, because your market's different. So before you go out and start investing money on Facebook or Google or time and effort and optimizing, you need to ask yourself, where does my market exist? And where are they most likely open to hearing about what I have to offer? This is why, for example, search has always been such a powerful source of targeted traffic. Because if you do search right, for example, you can make sure that when somebody searches a keyword that is a strong indicator that they really need what you have, if you can get your listing to come up either organically or through an ad, that could drive a really targeted visitor. That's the beauty of search, because people are telling us what they're looking for and we can say, oh, we have that. And we can avoid the people who are typing in keywords that maybe aren't targeted, right? Sure, search may be it, but guess what? There's lots of products that just don't sell on search. Why? Because people don't go to Google and search for them. What about social media? Yeah, social media across all the platforms can be a fantastic source of traffic, as long as there's a way for you to specifically target and reach your ideal customer. And if there's not a way to really hone in and target and reach out to people that you know with a high degree of confidence are going to be interested in what you have, then you can waste a ton of time and money. So for example, if I had a self-help program and I went and I targeted everybody who liked Tony Robbins, well, I can do that on social media. And I know if they like Tony Robbins, well, they're probably gonna like self-help stuff. So that's a great starting point. But if there's no very specific criteria that I can reach out to on social to get to these people, that can be very, very difficult. Even if you're using their algorithm and custom audiences and stuff like that, it can be tough to do. If you can find ways to use the targeting systems that exist within social media to reach your audience, great. You can do great there as well. If you can't, maybe that's not the right place. Maybe you need to be on search. My point is the right traffic for business A might not be the right traffic source for business B. So before you start investing a whole bunch of your time, money, and resource developing out a traffic channel, make certain that it's the right traffic channel for your niche. Don't get sucked in because everybody's like, oh, Instagram super hot or Snapchat super hot. Yeah, sure it is for the right market. There you go. Now, that was step number two. I've got you thinking about traffic the right way. In the next lesson, I want to wrap this up by talking about free traffic and paid traffic, and which one is the best. The battle of traffic. All right, I'll see you in that lesson, and click the link below. You'll find it right there.